Ricardo Montalban. I don't know.
Hey,
you
baby.
Can't tell them apart.
Yeah.
As for the Giants, I'll be out there tomorrow on the sideline getting a tan, try to get in Schrager's realm there of bronze. But I'll be watching Daniel Jones, and I'll be watching Eli Manning. I know there was some talk that Pat Shurmur late in the spring, when he left the door open, or seemingly left the door open to some folks for a quarterback competition, when he said that Eli Manning's getting ready for a big year and Daniel Jones is getting ready to play. No, that was really, from what I'm told in speaking to Giants people, Pat Shurmur just telling Daniel Jones in so many words, come to work every day and work towards something. Work towards the possibility that you're going to play, because we don't know when we're going to need you. And he also didn't want him to rest on his laurels, even though the Giants are confident that Daniel Jones is not that kind of a guy. So Eli Manning firmly entrenched as the starter. This is not a quarterback competition. However, if Daniel Jones starts to light it up during training camp and in the preseason, you know what people are going to be doing. They're going to be calling for the backup quarterback. Of course they are.
Of course, and these back pages in front of me surely will reflect that. Thank you so much. But let's stay in the NFC East now and talk about Zeke Elliott, who's still awaiting a new contract from the boys. What can you tell us about how things are or are not progressing so far?
TBD, Kay, and he's got some time. He's got a couple of more days before they can figure this one out, and the Cowboys will see if they can get closer, get something done. Ezekiel Elliott, look, there's no question that he has contemplated a holdout. Mike Florio, Pro Football Talk, reported that. We have followed up since and talked about that on our air. This is something that he has been mulling for quite some time. There was even some talk or some thought that maybe he wouldn't even show up in the spring, but he wound up doing that as well. And the Cowboys, for their part, have been with Zeke. They have sent lawyers to his meetings with Roger Goodell, this recent one that he had for the Las Vegas incident, as well as the one that led to a six-game suspension a couple of years ago. So other than the contract, they have tried to show their support for Elliott all along the way. But at some point, it does become a business. A guy wants a deal done. So that's why he's considered it. However, no firm decision. If he does show up for camp, I wouldn't be surprised. But we'll see how this plays out for the last couple of days here and whether they can get close or get a deal done in short order.
And that full squad training camp begins for those Cowboys on Friday. Thank you so much, Mike Garofalo. Kisses to Carmen from the breakfast table here in New York City. And let's talk about these Cowboys, shall we? Are we anticipating him showing up at training camp, given what Mike G sort of laid out for us? Or do we have another holdout on our hands, Riggs?
It's funny. This running back position is becoming the real tipping point in the NFL when it comes to contracts. The quarterbacks, they seem to be going along with it, but these running backs are actually putting their feet down. And last year at this time, Le'Veon Bell was the big topic. And I said it, a few other people said, a lot of running backs, Maurice Jones-Drew was very vocal about this, saying, someone needs to stand up for us right now. And Le'Veon did it. And it seems like here we are a year later, and maybe the effects of Le'Veon Bell saying, I'm willing to sit the season out, and I still got paid, are having some effects on these guys. It's not only Ezekiel Elliott, but it's Melvin Gordon, too. To me, Zeke, in the public eye right now, everyone knows what he does on the field. Everyone also knows he's had some issues off the field, so he doesn't have a lot of goodwill from the fans outside of Dallas saying, yeah, go for it, Zeke. But he is still the stir that stirs that drink in Dallas. And if he were to not show up the first day of training camp, forget all the Dak contract talk, forget all the Amari Cooper stuff, and forget the Super Bowl chatter. He's that important. They need Zeke Elliott there. Does he have the will and the conviction to not show up the first day of camp? That would be bold, but others have done it before.
Yeah, that would be bold. If I'm him, I would show up. You show up, you can't get paid if you don't show up, quite frankly, unless he's prepared to sit out the entire season and do the Le'Veon Bell thing. If I'm him, you show up. It's what have you done for me lately in this league? You show up, you go through walkthrough, you do certain things. You see what Julio is doing out there in Atlanta. He's working to the side when they do 11-on-11 drills. There are ways you can still be in the building, but not all the way put your body at risk. I think you show up because you owe your teammates that respect. You show up and you say, hey, look, guys, I am with you for this season, okay? Business has to be handled, so if you see me over here on the bike, you know why. And that, and then what starts to happen is your teammates are starting to look at Jason Garrett and all the people in the front office like, hey, bro, We can't do nothing without this guy. That is how you handle the contract situation in the National Football League. You don't just sit back and fight, especially with 2 years left on your contract. You don't have the leverage right now.
That's what upsets me. It's 2 years left. If Dak shows up, how does that look on Zeke? Yeah. Dak's going to show up as the quarterback and his deal isn't done and he's got less than a year? It's crazy.
He'll be there. He'll be there. I think that Zeke has a special relationship with the Jones family for reasons we know about and maybe some we don't know about. I mean, he's been some stuff and they've been there for him in a lot of ways. The optics would be terrible because what are we talking about with this deal? This is a business investment. We can't count on you, dude. Like, you're embarrassing us. Mike Garafolo is reporting there's this incident, there's another. That stuff matters. If we're going to invest in you, we got to know you're out there. The idea of Zeke going through that and then not showing up is a terrible look that will not play well for him at all. And the Dak thing is huge. Mm-hmm. Zeke is a top draft pick. He's been playing on that money. Dak's playing for peanuts, and he's the star quarterback, doesn't have a deal in the last year, and he's going to be there and say, yes, sir, let's run this offense. Zeke isn't. Looks terrible. He will be there.
KB, I don't think you can compare those.
What do you mean?
I don't think you can compare Dak and Zeke. Quarterbacks, for whatever reason, the next man up gets the biggest contract. It's not like, you know, nobody's going to make more than Tom Brady. That's not how, for whatever reason, we just keep paying quarterbacks. I think the quarterback pay scale is broken. Mm-hmm. But for whatever reason, when you look at the running back position, it's like, oh, we can find another running back or whatever. No, Ezekiel Elliott is an elite running back. He's one of the top two or three backs in this league. You can't just go out there and draft a guy in the fourth or fifth round, and that's going to be Ezekiel Elliott. It's just crazy to me how, like, we can compare those. To me, there's no comparison. You know what I mean? Quarterbacks are going to get paid no matter what. If I'm Dak, of course I'm showing up. I'm going to get $20-30 million no matter what. I'm going to show up. With Ezekiel, it's a little bit different.
We're in a new era with running backs, as we know, and the founding father of that area, Le'Veon Bell, he's not one of these guys who says, I don't look at my mentions. He looks at his mentions, and he has things to say about it.